Today we're starting on a hydroponic planter, and you can see the parts we've got. We'll go over them. Got some end caps. I'm using 4-inch pipe just because I had it left over from another project. So I got two end caps. Got two 90 degree turns, a connector piece, and another 90 degree turn. I've marked the pipe about every 15 centimeters because we're going to grow small stuff like lettuce and so on. So that's it for now, and we're getting ready to glue it up, and then we'll go from there. I've been working on some ways to control the height of the liquid in the tube, and one guy I know just took two pieces of plastic tubing, he cut a hole in it, and then he can slide the hole up and down inside the tubing, and wherever the hole is, of course, that's the level of the tube, the level of the water in the tube. What I wanted to do is I wanted to make it a little bit harder to bump or put out of alignment. So what I did is I've got this set up where you can see the hole up there. I can screw it down into this fitting down here, and I can control the height of the water where that hole is. I can screw it all the way down so that the hole is at the bottom, so there's no water in the tube. Or I can screw it all the way up. When it's all the way up, that is good for, you know, when you're first starting seedlings. So that's the idea. And of course, as the roots grow longer, you can lower the tube as the roots get longer, and you want to keep your liquid level down. So, as you can see, I've been experimenting with some different sizes and types and what have you. But this thing, when it's done, will fit on the end of the tube there. And you can see the planter just barely in there. So that's where we are now. This is the update. Things have been glued together. Holes have been cut with a hole saw here. I've got 18 of them so far. Thinking about putting one in here. I put on this extension just so the ends would be roughly even. I've added my flow level, or my level control here, which is a screw up, screw down type of thing. I'll show you inside here in a second. Put on these cleanouts with a end cap on it. They're overkill, but the local hardware store, that's all they had, so I didn't want to drive across town, too lazy. Well, here's the inside of the one tube, nothing special in there, just empty tube. And here's the level control. You can see I can screw that all the way up or down, set the level anywhere I want to. Down the bottom, I have a slip fitting I made from a 1-inch piece of pipe. Just cut it and put a clamp on it so that I can take this on and off. So that's the drain that will go back to the fluid box. And so far, that's about it. So you may wonder why I go to all the trouble of creating this screw type level control. And the answer is that a lot of people will start their plants in another container and then move them over as the roots grow. And what I want to do is I want to have my containers like this. I'll put my seeds up on the top of the sponge, let the sponge hang down a little bit, and then all I need is to have my water level just barely touch the sponge, and as the roots grow down, then I can lower the water level until there's just a thin film on the bottom. And I can do that just a little bit at a time by lowering the hole in the drain, and as that happens, I lower the water level until the roots are all the way to the bottom, and that's it. So this is this allows me to take the water to the roots rather than the roots to the water. So anyway, I'm hoping this will simplify things a lot. These are the stands I've made for my hydroponic garden. As you can see, they've got some unique legs on them. They've only got cross pieces on one side. That's so I can work around this side and not trip over them. This side will go up against the wall. just made from some scrap metal I had laying around, starting to rust away, so I thought I'd put it to good use. Made these so they aren't straight, just for some looks. Didn't want just like a square rectangular design. Not that anybody will ever see it, but anyway, some pieces to keep the tubes from sliding off. The pipes I were using were warped. They were actually bent in their earlier use, so I put the bending so it was like this, so the water wouldn't collect inside and rust away. Just some end pieces to keep the stuff from sliding away. I'm not going to put end caps on there because I want the water to come out if water gets in it. I want them to be dry. Got some adjustable legs on here. They're just screws, stainless steel screws. Welded a nut on the bottom. Anyway, just something to hold it up, and that's about it. Here's the hydroponic garden set up. It's not quite ready to go. I don't have the pump and whatever down here. I'm going to set up a test with the solar, electric, and a temporary system, see how it goes. But here's the planter. Here's the depth controller we saw earlier. The stands. I found that shimming it just works a lot easier than trying to screw the legs up and down. So there it is.